So the final item of business this evening is a member's business debate on motion 13436 in the name of Gordon MacDonald on importance of the Scottish wholesale sector. This debate will be concluded without any questions being put, and I would ask those members who would wish to speak in the debate to please press the request to speak buttons, and I call on Gordon MacDonald to open the debate. Around 7 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and I will take this opportunity to thank everyone across the Chamber who supported the motion in order it could be debated tonight. I should also refer members to my register of interest, as I am the convener of the cross-party group on independent convenience stores, of which the Scottish Wholesale Association has been a member since the CPG was formed. I also want to take this opportunity to thank Colin Smith, who is in the gallery tonight, and Jane Swanson from the Scottish Wholesale Association for their knowledge and guidance on the vital role the wholesale sector plays across Scotland. The Scottish Wholesale Association is a not-for-profit membership organisation based in Edinburgh, which was established in 1920 and is the official trade body representing Scottish food and drink wholesalers and distributors. Wholesale members of the association are located the length and breadth of Scotland and include single depot family-owned businesses as well as national wholesale groups. Members supply products to Scotland's 5,000 independent convenience stores, 30,000 catering, hospitality, tourism and leisure businesses, and to all other public sector establishments. The Scottish wholesale sector is a vital part of the Scottish economy, worth around £3.3 billion in the wholesale marketplace and directly employing over 6,000 people. Wholesalers across all parts of Scotland help to support over 49,000 local jobs in the independent convenience store sector. Those local jobs help local people into work, from a first job for a young person or an older person returning to work. The economy also benefits from shopping local and buying local produce, because those producers and retailers not only provide jobs in their own businesses, but support employment across the town or city in which they are located through the use of local tradesmen, produce suppliers, shop fitters, garages and local legal and accountancy firms. It is not always clear the link between wholesalers and local convenience stores, but members will recognise the trading names including Mace, Spar, Londis, Cost Cutter, Premier Stores and Nisa, to name but a few. These symbol groups, or cash and carries, support family-owned stores to compete with the large multinational supermarkets in many of our towns, villages and neighbourhood centres. But wholesalers are not only facing competition from supermarkets, there are also other challenges, including restructuring of the grocery market, including Amazon moving into selling groceries, wholesaler bypass, changing customer demands, Brexit and regulation. This is happening at the same time that the wholesale sector is facing low margins, recruitment issues and rising food costs. The result is a lack of private investment due to low investor confidence in the sector at a time when there should be investment in operational efficiency and the supply chain management. I recently visited Mark Murphy Limited, which is part of the Dole Food Service, at their warehouse at Bankhead Drive in my constituency. They are Scotland's largest fresh produce supplier to the hospitality sector and are among the constituency's biggest employers, with approximately 270 members of staff. I met with General Manager Brian Breslin, where he outlined not just the positive contribution the company makes to fresh produce supply across Scotland as the UK's Food Service Supplier of the Year for 2023, but also the challenges their business faces, predominantly in recruitment and retention. Despite offering above minimum wage, fixed shifts and permanent contracts, they continue to struggle to fill positions given the employment situation in Edinburgh. This was also reflected in the results of the Scottish Wholesale Association's recent wholesale market survey, which indicated recruitment and skill shortages remain a problem. However, the industry is trying to address this by taking steps to improve working conditions, including introducing the real living wage and a 4-day week. The sector has and continues to receive financial support from the Scottish Government, both during and post-pandemic, totalling approximately £20 million, as the Scottish Government recognises the vital role that the sector plays for our food and drink suppliers and for us as consumers. In 2021, the Scottish Wholesale Association launched Delivering Growth Through Wholesale, a training initiative with the aim to educate and engage with producers to highlight the opportunities provided by the wholesale sector. The training programmes were designed by the SWA in conjunction with the Scottish Agricultural Organisation Society and Scotland Food and Drink. Supported by the Scottish Government, the initiative equips local Scottish producers with the insights and strategies needed to successfully navigate the landscape of Scottish wholesale. The result today is that almost 150 Scottish producers have gone through the course, with 230 new Scottish product listings via 59 wholesale partnerships. Furthermore, the Scottish Wholesale Association have launched two additional initiatives with support from the Scottish Government as part of its wider Local Food for Everyone, Our Journey food strategy. The first initiative is a Wholesale Local Food Champion training programme, which was introduced in 2023. The Local Food Champion programme is an extension of the Association's Delivering Growth Through Wholesale Producer initiative. The programme provides training to those working with thin wholesale businesses with the knowledge they need to take responsibility for shaping the company's local sourcing strategy. And becoming a champion, of which there will be 40 by November of this year, they are taking an active role in creating a strong and sustainable local food and drink supply chain. The second initiative is the Scottish Wholesale Local Food and Drink Growth Fund, which is worth £195,000, thanks again to Scottish Government funding. This is the third phase of the Delivering Growth Through Wholesale Local Sourcing programme I mentioned earlier. Again, working with partners has been set up to support wholesalers who work closely with local Scottish producers, manufacturers, local authorities and other stakeholders to increase the volume and customer base of Scottish produce being sold through the wholesale channel. In closing, Presiding Officer, I want to highlight some of the findings of the Scottish Wholesale Association's recent market survey. The sector has seen positive growth in 2023 compared with 2022, with an average of 5% increase in turnover. Wholesale service is up 9% compared to 6% for the rest of the UK, and a very positive 30% increase in turnover from Scottish products, thanks to the Scottish Government's funded initiatives and delivered by the Scottish Wholesale Association. I want to put my thanks on record for the collaborative approach of the Scottish Wholesale Association working with the Government and industry to ensure the sector is nurtured and supported for all stakeholders.
Thank you, Mr. MacDonald. I now call David Torrens to be followed by Brian Whittle. Mr. Torrens.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'd like to thank Gordon MacDonald for bringing the motion to Chamber today, recognising the importance of the Scottish wholesale sector. As no stranger to the joys of food and drink myself, it is a privilege to celebrate the good work of the wholesaling sector in Scotland and the vital role it plays in our food and drink supply chain. The role of wholesaling in our day-to-day lives may go largely unnoticed by most, but it is the very quiet efficiency with which they run that calls for recognition. The Scottish Wholesalers Association describes wholesalers as the wheels of Scotland's food and drink industry, providing vital connections between suppliers and end users such as retailers, hotels, restaurants, schools and other public sector organisations. The industry supports a wide range of jobs from delivery and production roles to manufacturing, right up to procurement, administration and management. Scotland's wholesale marketplace is now worth up to £3.3 billion and indirectly employs 6,500 people. Most of the people in this room have benefited from wholesaling today, from a pint of milk picked up in a hurry from a local corner shop, to a quick lunch in the work canteen, to a special dinner out at a pub. It is inevitable that our lives are quietly but consistently touched by wholesaling. In my own constituency of Kirkcaldy, I can name many wholesalers providing employment and driving the local and national economy, Chief among them would have to be Fife Creamery, which, like 90% of Scottish-owned wholesalers, small to medium-sized enterprise with strong connections to its local community. Founded in 1957 by former dairyman John Simpson, offering a selection of chilled dairy, it is now a modern, thriving wholesale business. They employ 160 people and claim an impressive turnover, and that success creates a ripple effect through the food sector. In fact, in 2019, I was honoured to attend the opening of a training centre on site, joined by then the Scottish Minister for Rural Affairs, Mary Goujon. As a multi-use hub, the space is dedicated to connecting food producers with end-user buyers in a variety of ways. We hope this wholesaler is leading the way, building up their own business, supporting other businesses to grow, and acting as a central hub for food services businesses throughout my constituency. One of the most impressive results of a new centre is a three-day food innovation hub run by Fife Creamery. It aims to identify new innovative products and to support producers who might otherwise struggle to get their product to customers. Case in point, they recently facilitated the launch of a dog ice cream based off the back of the most recent session. And as the owner of Hollywood's 2023 Dog of the Year, I'd like to say that Buster and I are intrigued and also delighted. In all seriousness, the Scottish wholesalers are the backbone of our food and drinks industry. They act as the nation's larder, ensuring security for provision across the length and breadth of Scotland. The Scottish Wholesale Association recently commissioned a survey from amongst its members, with a result that shows various stress points across the industry. Noted concerns included economic strain due to Brexit and other wider geopolitical disruptions, the availability and cost of products and packaging from suppliers, all within the backdrop of inflation and a reported increase in regulatory and domestic policy pressures. Add to this the increase of energy costs that have caused economic havoc across all sectors, and the survey points to some clear issues of concerns for wholesalers. It is important that the sector is celebrated and listened to, and I again thank Gordon MacDonald for highlighting the issue. Whether it be either through local shops, food services, business or pub, we all rely on the success of wholesaling. In conclusion, Presiding Officer, I'd like to take this moment to express my appreciation for the Scottish wholesaling sector, to highlight the success of the wholesalers in my constituency. We would all be worse off in the wholesaling sector weren't as strong as it is, and we'd do well to support their continued success. The concerns outlined by the Scottish Wholesale Association represents a welcome first step in how we might work to support wholesalers across Scotland so that a strong, vibrant food and drink network can continue to flourish.
Thank you, Mr Torrens. I now call Brian Whittle to be followed by Faisal Chowdhury. Mr Whittle.
Thank you very much, Deputy Presiding Officer. Can I also add my congratulations to Gordon MacDonald for securing the time in Parliament to recognise the importance of the Scottish wholesale sector. I think this is a sector that's often the forgotten link in the chain when it comes to the food and drink that ends up at our tables. And it was really during COVID that it really came to my notice when a wholesaler in my region, Brayhead Food, came to me for help. The then MD explained to me that they order in advance sometimes as much as £100,000 worth of stock. And of course, along comes lockdown with little notice, meaning a lot of that product would not be able to be delivered to the retailers. Now, it didn't go to waste. They donated the food to charities, which was great, but there were still hundreds of thousands of pounds out of pocket. Unfortunately, they weren't in a sector initially covered by the furlough scheme. But as Gordon MacDonald indicated, there are some 35,000 businesses relying on wholesale suppliers. And without the wholesalers, the supply chain would collapse. They are the unseen and perhaps unheralded link between producers and retailers. Now, I did urgently bring this to the attention of the Cabinet Secretary, and to her credit, recognised the gap immediately and the key role that wholesale plays in the supply chain, and allocated that £20 million to the sector to ensure it was robust through the COVID pandemic and beyond. Without the wholesale sector, producers would not be able to get their produce to market, and retailers would be without a supplier. And I have had the pleasure of visiting Brayhead Foods many times to see the crucial role they play in the food and drink supply chain. And a big shout out to them, because not only do they supply retailers across the country, they're also supplying to Premiership football clubs, not only in Scotland, but also clubs such as Tottenham and Chelsea, south of the border. Deputy Presiding Officer, our world-class producers do their thing, and our retailers present those world-class products to the public. The glue in the middle is our wholesalers, who make sure there is a buyer for our producers and there is a supply to those retailers. They are an essential sector, so often forgot. So can I just say, once again, can I thank Gordon MacDonald for bringing this debate to the Chamber to highlight the huge success of our wholesale sector in keeping the supply chain moving. Deputy Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Mr Whittle. I now call Faisal Chowdhury to be followed by Liam MacArthur. Mr Chowdhury.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. I would like to begin by congratulating Gordon MacDonald on bringing this to the Chamber. It is great to have the opportunity to pay tribute to an industry which employs so many and contributes so much to the Scottish economy. The wholesale sector has shown resilience in recent years, responding to the challenges from the pandemic, affecting supply chains and navigating inflationary pressures more recently. If we are to kickstart the growth of the Scotland economy and promote the food and drink sector globally, the wholesale industry has a vital role to play. On the 4.3 billion mentioned in the motion, Edinburgh and Lothian contributes considerably. Edinburgh has up to 30,000 jobs in wholesale and retails, with wholesalers in meat, fish, bathroom, beer, wine and shortbreads, all this selling to the other local businesses. The wholesale sector has a large role to play in the promotion of local food and produce. I welcome the work of the Scottish Wholesale Association, who I know Gordon MacDonald has met with before to boost local food producers, particularly through their Local Food and Drink Growth Fund, which aims to increase the turnover of Scottish produce sold through Scottish wholesalers up to 35%. By supporting wholesalers in working closely with the Scottish producers and manufacturers, I would also like to note their scheme, Delivering Growth Through Wholesale, which works to improve the understanding of the opportunities brought by the wholesale sector. Through wholesale, local food producers have the opportunity to bring their products to a wider audience, increasing their sales and providing more opportunities for growth. It is positive that 30% of the Scottish wholesalers' turnover is coming from Scottish products. That is money reinvested into the Scottish economy. I hope that number will grow, but more need to be done. There is a great potential in the food and drink sector to drive economic growth and tourism. As part of Brand Scotland, we should be doing all we can to use our food and drink sector to promote Scotland as a global destination for premium products. Scotland leads the UK in food and drink products exports with salmon and whisky. Other Scot products can be brought to the same level. The wholesale sector can play a role in this through selling local products either at home or internationally. We need to ensure that we recognise the value of the wholesale sector to the economy currently, but equally recognise the great potential they have in promotional food and drink. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr Chowdhury. And I now call Liam MacArthur. Mr MacArthur.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. And can I add my thanks to Gordon MacDonald? I recognise the hard work that he puts in advocating on behalf of the wholesale sector and indeed the retail sector in this chamber and beyond. I too welcome the opportunity to offer, I think, richly deserved recognition of the importance of the Scottish wholesale sector and the central role that it plays within the Scottish economy. But in recognising that economic contribution, both locally and indeed nationally, I think it's also important we acknowledge some of the challenges that colleagues have referred to that the sector has faced and continues to face, especially in the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic. And indeed, the pandemic, as in so many other ways, I think certainly brought home to me, and I suspect many others, how integral wholesalers are within the communities we represent, Gordon MacDonald, I think referenced the multiplier effect that the wholesalers have, and I think others have described how wholesalers sit almost within the centre of the web. I think Brian Whittle talked about the representations he made through COVID and the experience he had engaging with local wholesalers probably for the first time. I would probably draw exception to the fact of him claiming credit for the fact that the entire £20 million was delivered to the sector. But I think the point he made about the pandemic, I think, bringing home to many of us what wholesalers do was one I very much recognised. In my own Orkney constituency, I was indebted to people like James Leonard at Stromness-based wholesalers, James Wilson, for the insights he was able to provide about what was and wasn't working in terms of getting vital goods to where they needed to be, not just in the network of local shops, which came into their own during the pandemic, but he was also able to explain the role Wilson's played in ensuring local schools, care homes, and indeed the staff and patients at the Balfour Hospital had the food and other goods that they needed through that difficult period. This weekend, the Scottish Parliament marks its 25th anniversary in the presence of local heroes from around the country, and I would argue that many in our wholesale sector fall firmly within that category. And as in so many other ways, wholesalers have to adapt to island circumstances. In Orkney, for example, wholesalers regularly and routinely hold twice the stock levels of their mainland counterparts. We're invariably at the end of supply chains, and given the transport and logistical challenges we face and the risks posed to local residents and businesses in the event of ferry disruption, for example, island wholesalers have had to adapt and build in more headroom. In turn, this involves more costs and risk, and it's no surprise, therefore, that wholesalers like Wilson's and JW Grey find themselves operating on tighter profit margins compared to their counterparts on the Scottish mainland. Increased procurement costs, third-party haulage charges and fuel surcharges all add to the pressure on island wholesalers, who seek to insulate customers and ensure as far as possible both stable and fair pricing levels, inevitably having an impact on those margins. In this regard, I'd certainly urge the Minister to pay particular attention to the island-specific challenges around procurement and operation costs. Certainly, I would argue that this should be reflected in the provision of financial resources and support going forward. When you add to this difficulties related to staff recruitment and retention, linked to traditionally low levels of unemployment in somewhere like Orkney, it's clear that island wholesalers do need to be considered slightly differently by government, both at a Scottish level, but I would argue at a UK level too. That said, and to finish perhaps on a more upbeat note, I welcome some of the reports around stronger growth in recent times, and also the fact that the sector does appear to be performing slightly better maybe than counterparts elsewhere in the UK. In the effort to reduce emissions and achieve our net zero ambitions, I was also encouraged to hear about the UK-wide wholesale roadmap to net zero by 2040. SWA have identified that leading source of emissions within the Scottish sector relate to the use of heavy goods vehicles and the use of electricity and fuel to heat buildings. At the local level, the wholesale sector in Orkney has committed to decarbonise heating systems and reduce energy costs through microgeneration, although these efforts have not been helped by capacity constraints on the local grid. Reducing the efficiency of solar power-based energy systems and associated savings on energy costs of as much as 75%. Again, I think this is somewhere where the Scottish Government may be able to assist. But, Presiding Officer, again, I thank Gordon MacDonald for allowing this debate to take place and put on record again my thanks to those in the wholesale sector for the vital work they do in my community and in communities around the country. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr MacArthur. And I now call on Minister Jim Fairley to respond to the debate. Around 7 minutes, please.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. And I would very much like to thank Gordon MacDonald for securing this debate and for all the work that he does with the grocery sector, because he works incredibly hard. But I'd also like to thank colleagues across the chamber for their valuable and positive contributions. And I say this with all sincerity, it's a good debate to have because the wholesale sector is a very good news story. But as Brian Whittle says, it's very much a sector that flies under the radar. It's an unsung, unrecognised hero of our fabulous food and drink sector. So it's absolutely right that the Parliament comes together to acknowledge that hugely significant role that the wholesalers play in our national food and drink supply chain and in food resilience. But I'd like to add my own personal bit as well. There is a company, Failsha Foods, during my days where we did festival catering. We could be working for enormously long days, working 12, 14, 16 hours a day. And you could phone Failsha up at any given time and change your order and they deliver it at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. That level of customer service is epitomised right across the wholesale sector. So I just wanted to put that bit on the record. They really are a fantastic sector. But if you'll pardon the pun, when it comes to linking up the food and drink sector, our wholesalers are the oil in the wheels, ensuring that all corners of the country, from the borders to the highlands and the islands, these folk are keeping the sector moving and interlinked. And the very point that Liam McArthur was just making, with a rural and islands lens on, this is a vital service that is very much needed. And as Liam McArthur has said, they have very different challenges in the islands, and that's something that we need to be cognisant of. But I hope that the industry understands the Scottish Government holds the sector in extremely high regard. And that's why we've developed this strong collaborative partnership with the Scottish Wholesale Association. And I'm delighted to see Colin sitting in the chamber tonight. It's a partnership that has seen the delivery of a number of programmes over recent years, most notably with supporting the sector when they were most severely impacted by the closure of the wholesale marketplace during the pandemic 21, as a number of colleagues have mentioned. Working hand in glove with the Scottish Wholesale Association, we were able to provide support to affected businesses the length and breadth of Scotland through the Scottish Wholesale Food and Drink Resilience Fund. Now, that critical intervention, introduced by my colleague Fergus Ewing, was a vital lifeline to many businesses, and it certainly helped to keep the resilience in a time of great uncertainty. There was a £10.2 million intervention over two lockdowns, and we were the only country in the UK to actually give that sector that kind of funding, so I think that's another vital point to put on the record. And the collaboration continues to this day, and it is helping us to distribute and grow Scotland's plentiful food and drink resources, from local farmers and producers through to some of Scotland's largest manufacturers. And as my colleague Gordon MacDonald says, we continue our commitment to the wholesale sector through ongoing funding for the third year of the Scottish Wholesale Association's Delivering Growth Through Wholesale programme. Gordon's already outlined what that does in phase two of the programme. So the successful delivery of the Wholesale Local Food programme. And these are the champions who collectively take responsibility for shaping the local sourcing strategy within their businesses and are helping increase wholesaler purchasing of local produce. Now, clearly, everyone that knows me knows that that is an aim that is very close to my heart. Alongside the dedicated one-to-one training seminars, the programme also links champions with regional food groups and Meet the Buyer events. And these initiatives are critical to the success of other Scottish Government investments in the local food supply chain, including the Scottish Grocers Federation Go Local programme and the food and drink industry strategy Sustaining Scotland, Supplying the World. So with my connectivity hat on, I'll quickly mention the role that the wholesale sector is playing in the transition to net zero. Again, something that Liam McArthur has touched on. Through the Scottish Wholesale Association, the sector has developed the decarbonisation reports, baselined their members' emissions and created route maps to net zero. And over they've used this deep knowledge to shape Scotland's HGV decarbonisation pathway, launched in March, and they're also working collaboratively with other sectors of the food and drink supply chain to share best practice and knowledge. So in closing, Presiding Officer, I want to put on record my thanks to all the wholesalers across the country for their work and for the commitment to the Scottish food and drink sector, to all these businesses that are playing a huge and often undervalued part in ensuring that we've got a food and drink industry that we can be proud of, and we should rightly be proud of it. I look forward to continuing working closely with wholesalers to create a strong, sustainable local food and drink supply chain for years to come. And it is, after all, an industry that combines commitment, enthusiasm and professionalism with delivery. Innovation is success with the food and drink products that are renowned the world over. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Minister. That concludes the debate, and I close this meeting.